Hey everyone, this is the Lego City Bus Station set, which I would say is misnamed. It's not really a bus station, is it? It's a bus set that also comes with a bus stop and plenty of people. Okay, since the focus of the set is the bus, let's look at the bus. First of all, it's pretty sizable. I think they easily could have made this a quarter shorter in overall length, maybe even a third shorter, and it still would have looked like a proper good-sized bus, but they really committed. And it ends up being almost the length of an entire base plate, especially when you have a bike on the rack on the back. So I appreciate that commitment to really making a large-sized bus in a set that's not much larger than just the vehicle itself, to be honest. You can see inside there is plenty of room, and I'll give you a better look at the interior detail and how seating works out, but it's nice to see all the way in there. However, it's plainly obvious here that they were not thinking about the whole left-hand drive, right-hand drive thing. You know, it's not the same everywhere in the world, yet they only made one model. I think they should have considered that, because obviously you can mirror the build. Especially when it comes to the center doors, you know, you got double doors there, but the front door, unfortunately, you know, only goes one way, and it wouldn't make much sense to put this on the other side. You can do it, but it would have been nice to include that one extra part for, oh, I don't know, the entire rest of the world. But the doors work well. I'm not sure about the styling. The old train style doors doesn't really go with the relatively blockiness, the more square shape of the windows, just this porthole here. But they work properly. They give you room to get a wheelchair in and out. They actually have a ramp to help with that. I'll show you in a minute. They've got a good one at the front with just a single step. And the overall layout is good. The build was very, very easy, very simple. It would be nice to see this with more detail, you know, more texture and such, more little things on it, but this is a lower end Lego City set. This is designed for kids, according to what they suggest on the box, for kids as young as 5. So they couldn't make it too complex. They didn't want it to be too frustrating for younger and especially more inexperienced builders. And this goes together very, very easily. And they even introduced a new part for this year, which helps to reduce the parts count for this entire roof and just makes it simpler while still maintaining that nice little chamfered edge that is initiated by the 6-wide roof piece, which is used at the front here and also at the rear. However, the bad thing about this is that they haven't given you any good way to remove those parts. To get to the interior, you need to start removing these large panel pieces, these roof components. But there's no good place, there's not even a place to get your fingernail under there, except maybe just right there if you want to come in from the corner. So there's just no ridge on the bottom of these like they do with jumpers and such and with tiles. And they didn't use any tiles on the gray layer going through here either. So that's essentially plates from the side. So getting into this thing is a little more difficult than it ought to be. No, it's a lot more difficult than it ought to be. Once you get one up, then it starts to go more easily. You can just kind of peel from the front, but you can see the pieces that are being used have a lot of studs on them, and they start to kind of pull up the sides. There you go. Look at that. It's pulling up the sides of the thing. These roof pieces really don't want to come off. That's so odd. It's the opposite of what I would have expected. I would have expected this roof to practically fall off. Once you take all those pieces off, though, you still have these cross members that are in the way, and that really restricts your ability to get in there and access the figures to put ones in and to take ones out or to change their poses if you want to have somebody getting ready to get off at an upcoming stop or something like that. So, you know, you just really have to squeeze your fingers in, and in some cases it might actually be better to do something like this, you know, come in from both sides to try to get a little balanced pinching of a person to get them out. Definitely could have been done better there. So here I went ahead and took off a couple of those pieces to give you, the viewer of this video, a better look at the interior without things in the way. The driver's compartment is nice with his seat that has elevation over the entrance walkway. They've got a printed tile piece over on the side to represent where you would, you know, pay up your fare or use a transit pass or something. He's got the all-important Lego City coffee mug, so that's all good. And then inside, yeah, there's a good amount of space, plenty of space for the wheelchair there, or you can put, like I said, a baby carriage of some design. I haven't actually seen what design will fit in there. I'm assuming the one from Fun in the Park will work. Child figures do have to stand up just because they're not able to bend their legs, but there's plenty of space to stand for sure. You can sit a figure right there as well, and then you have three more easy to access seats in the back, and you can kind of, you know, change up the configuration a little bit. They do have to stagger from side to side in order to have the figures clearing each other's arms, but that works well enough, especially once you've taken these pieces off so you can actually get them in there. This bike rack is kind of ingenious. This is one of the best systems I've ever seen for setting up a bike rack like this. It's not the most detailed, it's not the most realistic, but it sure works well and it's very sturdy. This goes on, has just a little bit of pressure, and it doesn't want to just fall off. The piece is holding it on, the piece is holding the bike on, the rack itself, that's all sturdy. That does not want to fall off. This is really, really well done. I like that so much. And they have space for two bikes, and they include two bikes in the set. Perfect. So, two little slots, just put this one on there. Yeah. So, handlebars. Handlebars are impacting each other, aren't they? Yes. Yes, they are. That is not very cool. You have to get it just right. So, turn one upside down. Get it like that. Now this one is just kind of flopping around and wants to fall off easily. So, what looked genius is for one bike, but looks like it'll work perfectly just as well for two. It doesn't, unfortunately. You can make it work, but it requires a little bit of force, a little bit of illegal connection that's not particularly happy. These are pushed up against each other. I say it works, but this, one of them really wants to get pushed off. It looks like they're wedged in there well enough, but yeah, it's not quite as good as it looked at first. The whole thing about the name, bus station, for the set, well, here's the bus stop. You know, it's just a little shelter, a little rain shelter, and, you know, it's just a small covered bus stop. I think that as a bus stop, it's really nice. I like the advertisement on the side. Comes with a bike rack, which works just fine like they usually do. I mean, you're just setting the bike there. And, you know, it's open, it's airy, it has a recycling bin there, or garbage bin, however you want to see it. Unfortunately, the bench really only holds one figure at a time. It looks like it's wide enough to hold a couple, but, you know, a second figure is just not going to fit in there. There's just not enough room. If they had made this just a little bit wider, you know, I think they could have left the garbage bin out. Just leave that out in the rain, leave that outside, give us room to at least put two figures in there. Of course, you can stand figures up, but it's a little bit disappointing for actual practical use in terms of just sitting folks down. Now, the little thing off to the side is the ramp that is used for wheelchair access to the bus, and, you know, just helps folks to get up. It doesn't come all the way up to the full level of the floor. The floor of the bus, honestly, is kind of high. I mean, they tried to lower it down, but once they add in the layers of pieces to bring in the color and also the structure, it ended up being a little bit high up. And then again, for access, you know, it's not very convenient to get your fingers around this thing. You can make it happen, but yeah, there we go. I guess that's okay, but you know, if you could get into the bus through the roof easily, it would be a lot easier to make this happen, to make the loading and unloading, you know, seem more comfortable for the rider. And then last up, there is this newsstand, which I think is very nice. It's very small, very, very small. Look at that, it's only four studs deep in total, including a little bit of walkway in the front of it, but I think it looks good. I like the accessories, I like the texture, I like the color scheme, I like the single sticker that's used there to add a lot of character to this. It has plenty of newspapers. They're all the same brand of newspaper, the Lego News, but it the whole thing looks the part. They also have a couple of apples in the bin over here. It looks like a garbage bin, but it's, I guess you could use it as a garbage bin if you want, but I think it's supposed to represent just a little, you know, little fruit stand. You could actually buy a snack from here, because they also sell some drinks that you can see behind this window. I don't know if that's supposed to be refrigerated, chilled or something. It's not really closed in completely from the back, but for the size of this thing, I think it's pretty close to perfect. I really couldn't ask for much more from this. And I think adding in the light here is just a little bit of extra bonus. A lot of folks will probably want to just take that light and use it as a street light or something. This whole thing I like. I love the selection of minifigs in this set, with the nice variety with the prints for the faces and the torsos. They have a number of newer torso prints in here, and everybody except for the driver on the left is very generic. They could be anything. They could represent anything. These are torsos that can be swapped easily. There's no matching between the torso and the face, or the torso and the legs. So this really just gives you an addition to your tool set for making your own people however you want them in your own Lego world. They also use some of the less common colors for parts, which again just adds to diversity and helps to break up some of the monotony that we've gotten over the years, especially with Lego City stuff, with many of the faces being reused countless times, and some of the types of designs used for torsos sometimes being updated but still looking pretty much the same or very similar. So in all, I'm actually not that keen on this set. I'm surprised by that. I expected this to be one of the great basic LEGO City foundational sets for the summer, but it's really not, because the bus just doesn't work as well as it ought to. I appreciate the simplicity of the build, but there are a lot of usability issues with it, regardless of your age or your skill level, especially with getting that roof off and then getting access inside. I think that it has plenty of space. I think that the floor plan of it is actually good. It could be made even more efficient, I believe, but again, for a simple build, I think that it's nice, but just getting access to that is the tough thing. And this whole suggestion of putting a second bike back there, yeah, as you saw, it can be done, but just not easily at all. The figures are great. New stand is nice, and the bus stop itself is good. It's not a bus station, but you know, a name is just a name. Unfortunately, the main thing that you're paying for is the bus itself, and that definitely has some deficiencies. So sorry, not a huge fan of this set on the whole, especially when you consider that in the US it costs $50. That's kind of rough on the price to part ratio, even though it does have a fair number of larger pieces. So those are my thoughts, but aside from what I think about it, you've actually seen the product now with your own eyes. Let me know what you think about this. Do you agree and wish that this was done better? Again, do keep in mind that this is designed for folks of all ages, including some of the younger fans. But yeah, just let me know what you think about this on the whole from your perspective. I would appreciate that very much. Thank you, as always, for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this. I hope I showed you everything that you wanted to see about this set. I'll be talking to you again very soon, because my next video is on the way.